In this tutorial, you'll learn how to create bouncing animations like this using the Transform preset. The advantage is that you can create multiple animations using just one layer and one effect. And the best part is, you can move these animations anywhere in your comp without touching a single keyframe. Stick around to find out how. Hey everybody, and welcome back to another exciting and informative episode of 7-Minute AE Tutorials, where you learn tips, tricks, and shortcuts in 7 minutes or less. No BS, just AE. This episode is sponsored by the good folks over at AE Juice. Check out their site by visiting the link in the description below to get amazing savings, as well as AE assets that are 100% free. If you're a serious motion graphic designer, you'll be super happy you discovered AE Juice. I highly recommend the I Want It All bundle, which gives you access to everything they offer. Check out their promo at the end of this tutorial and visit them today using the link in the description below. Make sure to tell them that Jeff Knight from 7-Minute AE Tutorials sent you. Trust me, you won't regret it. Please comment, like, share, and subscribe, and click the bell so you're notified every time I upload a new video. Support our channel by getting your 7-Minute AE merch today at our online store. And sign up for my Udemy course, The Power of Shape Layers. It's guaranteed to make you a shape layer rock star. The link to that course, to our 7-Minute AE store, to this episode's sponsor, and the project files are all in the description below. I've also included a table of contents so that way you can go back and rewatch sections that you found difficult. Okay, there's a lot to get through, so let's dive right in. Okay, so let's go up to Layer, New, Shape Layer. Let's open up the Shape Layer settings here. Go to the Add button. We're going to add in a rectangle. I'm going to add in a fill. Now, I'm going to open up my rectangle path settings and just change my size settings to 200 pixels by 200 pixels. With Shape Layer selected, let's go up to Effect, Distort, Transform. If we open up the transform settings for our layer, we see we have anchor point position, scale, rotation, and opacity. And then for the transform effect, we have the same settings in addition to a few other things like skew axis, and the shutter angle and sampling options. But by using the transform effect, you can affect your position, scale, rotation, and opacity in a lot of different ways while still retaining the ability to use your layer's transform properties. So I'm going to just create a simple little bounce animation using the position settings of our transform effect. So let's go down to the layer level here, and we're just going to close everything up and then focus on our effect. So open up transform. Let's put a keyframe at the beginning of our animation for position. And shift page down to go forward 10 frames, put another keyframe, and then page down 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 for a third keyframe, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 for a fourth keyframe. So this animation will just be 4 keyframes. If you want more of a bounce, you can add additional keyframes. I like to go ahead and put all of my keyframes in first before affecting their values. This makes it easier when you're trying to calculate how far you want to overshoot in order to get the bounce effect. So let's go back to this first keyframe, and we're going to move this off screen to the bottom. And if I pull back, we can see this is the center of that rectangle right there. And then let's go to the second keyframe and let's overshoot by 100 pixels. So 540 minus 100 is 440. This third keyframe, let's overshoot by 60. So 540 plus 60 is 600. So this is the basic look we have right here without touching the speed of our keyframes. Select these last three keyframes, right click, keyframe assistant, easy ease. Let's select the second keyframe, go into our graph editor, and just pull these handles away from the center so it comes in fast, kind of hangs, and then continues on. Okay, and I also want to create an animation out. So let's go to about maybe the 3-second mark, and then let's select all these keyframes, Command or Control C to copy, then Command or Control V to paste, right click, keyframe assistant, time reverse keyframes. And now if we watch this, we kind of get this extra little bounce that I don't really want with this animation. So if we put our playhead at the second keyframe, then select these last two and just overwrite the second keyframe with the third, because we only need 3 keyframes for this animation out. So it's our animation in, and then it kind of goes up and drops out. Okay, and now we'll be making multiple animations just with this one effect. So if you go to the effects controls panel, click on transform, hit return. I'm going to call this from bottom. Let's close that effect up. Command or Control D to duplicate and call this from top. And now make sure you hide this from bottom effect, so that way only the from top effect is visible. Now at the layer level, we're going to close up from bottom, open up from top. Just go to this first keyframe, and if you select position, notice it highlights all of your keyframes here. So let's change this value 960 by 540, and now that changes all of our keyframes values to 960 by 540. So we're going to do basically the same thing we did for the other animation, but coming from the opposite direction. So we'll make this first keyframe come in from off screen from the top. And now we want to overshoot by 100 pixels in the opposite direction. So if you remember in our first animation, we went up to 440. We can see right here. So let's make this 640. In the first animation, the third keyframe was set to 600 because we overshot by 60 pixels. So again, we want to go in the opposite direction. 540 minus 60 is 480. I'm going to close this back up so we can focus on this. And then if we watch that playback, we can see it's the same kind of animation, but just coming from the top. And now we need to change our animation out. Select all of these and get rid of those. Highlight our animation in keyframes. Command or Control C, Command or Control V to paste. Again, we want to right click, keyframe assistant, time reverse, put our playhead at this second keyframe. And then again, grab these last two keyframes and just overwrite that second keyframe. We can see it comes in from the top. And then it animates out to the top also. Okay, we're just going to do this two more times really quick, coming from the left and the right. So let's close up from top. Command or Control D to duplicate. Change it to from left. At the layer level, we'll close up from top. Make sure we turn that effect off. Open up from left. And now let's go to the beginning of the animation. Click on position and make all the keyframes 960 by 540. Again, notice all of the keyframes have been highlighted. So we kind of scrub through here. We can see that it has no movement. Now we'll be affecting the X values instead of the Y values. So this first keyframe will come in from the left. We want to overshoot by 100 pixels. So 960 plus 100 is 1060. And then we go back the opposite direction, 60 pixels. 960 minus 60 is 900. And again, we need to change our animation out keyframe. So just grab those, delete them, copy our animation in keyframes, Command or Control C, Command or Control V, right click, keyframe assistant, time reverse, put our playhead at this second keyframe. And then again, we want to grab these last two keyframes and just overwrite. So this is our animation from left. And we'll just make one more animation here real quick. Command or Control D to duplicate. I'm going to call this from right, turn that from left effect off. The layer level, make sure we only have from right showing. Go to the beginning of the animation, click on position, and we'll make sure the value is 960 by 540 to center everything up. Okay, and so we want to come in from the right. Second keyframe, overshoot by 100 in the opposite direction. So 860, overshoot the third keyframe by 60 is 1020. Okay, and again, we have to change our animation out keyframes, copy our animation in, Command or Control C, Command or Control V. Right click, keyframe assistant, time reverse. Play it at the second keyframe and again, pull these keyframes over. So this is our animation coming from the right. I want to save this as an animation preset. Close all this stuff up and make sure you have contents, effects, and transform all selected. Animation, save animation preset. You go to documents, Adobe, the version you're using. I'm in 2021, user presets, and I'm going to put this in 7 minute AE. And I'm just going to call this bounce underscore animation. Hit save. We can actually just get rid of this shape layer altogether. Go to our effects and presets panel, go to our user presets, 7 minute AE. Make sure your playhead is at the beginning of your timeline because whenever you have keyframes, the preset will drop in the first keyframe wherever your playhead may be. So let's just double click this bounce animation and notice it came in with the shape layer. Hit U, we have all of our keyframes here. And we have all the same exact settings that we had before. Now, the thing that's cool about using the transform preset is that now you have full control over your layer's transform properties. Let's hit P for position. We can duplicate this now. So Command or Control D to get a second copy and do it one more time. Highlight all these layers and hit P for position. And let's just offset these by 600 pixels. Subtract that by 600, 360. Leave this middle shape right where it is. Go to the third shape and add 600, so 1560. Now we can offset these maybe by 5 frames, and you can do all kinds of cool things with this now. So say like if you want your middle square here, maybe you want that to come in from the top instead of the bottom. So now you can move these shapes anywhere you want. You can affect the scale, the rotation, anything else without having to affect any of the animation keyframes. So see, if we were to do this animation using just the position of our layer, well, we wouldn't be able to have all of these other options. Like if we wanted it to come from the left or the right, we'd have to go in and manually change each one of these keyframes. But by using the transform effect, we can create the animation using a transform property such as position while still retaining the ability to move these shapes wherever we want within our comp. So let's go back to the beginning of our timeline here, select all the layers, hit your left bracket to bring them all over to the left here. Change our position to 960 by 540 on one of these, and notice they all change. These are all coming in at the same place. So now if we want to stack them vertically, all we have to do is change our Y value. So the Y values of these are 540. Let's separate them by maybe 300 pixels. So we'll say 240, and then 540 plus 300 is 840. So they're like this. Now all we have to do is just toggle these transform properties to be left or right. Make sure you only have one effect chosen. So we'll say this is from left. We'll say this one is from right. And maybe this last one is from left. You just have a lot more control over these animations if you use the transform effect instead of using your layer's transform properties. And you can do the same kinds of animations with scale or with rotation or anything else. If you do that using the transform effect, you still have full control over your layer's scale properties. And that's very important because it gives you a lot of control over how these animate and allows you to make quick duplicates while not having to affect any of the keyframes.
I'd like to thank the good folks over at AE Juice for sponsoring this video. If you haven't checked them out at aejuice.com, I highly recommend you do just that right now. Get tons of free plugins from AE Juice that will save time while adding polish and professionalism to your projects. Get the AE Juice Starter Pack, which contains over 100 assets for your projects, including liquid and shape elements, liquid transitions, slides for your slideshows, text presets, flat icons, 2D and 3D assets, and so much more. AE Juice also offers professionally produced sound effects absolutely free. Other free plugins include a HUD package that is super cool. These elements would literally take hours to create, but with AE Juice, you get them absolutely free and they can be dropped into your project with the click of a button. Some of my personal favorite free plugins include Copy Ease, which allows you to copy the speed graph of your keyframes and paste them so you get identical keyframe speeds. I also use Shifter on a regular basis. Instead of going through the multiple steps of offsetting layers, this plugin allows you to do it with the click of a button, which saves a tremendous amount of time. In addition to these impressive free plugins, you can also purchase advanced products at more than reasonable prices. Take advantage of AE Juice's bundles. My personal recommendation is that you get the I Want It All bundle, which includes everything I just showed you. I've been approached by several sponsors, and I will not promote their products unless I support them, use them, and highly recommend them. AE Juice is an amazing product and company, and in my opinion, it's a necessity for any serious motion graphic designer. AEJuice.com.
I hope this tutorial helped you out and that you learned something new and useful. Make sure to come back next time for another tutorial that will expand your knowledge of After Effects while also teaching you some really cool tips, tricks, and shortcuts. Please comment, like, share, and subscribe. And click the bell so you're notified every time I upload a new video. Support our channel by getting your 7-Minute AE merch today at our online store. And sign up for my Udemy course, The Power of Shape Layers. It's guaranteed to make you a shape layer rock star. The link to that course, to our 7-Minute AE store, and the project files for this episode are all in the description below. As always, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.